Where does your household garbage end up? Have you ever really thought about what happens to your toothpaste tubes or your worn-out underwear? In the can it goes, only to be gone forever and ever. Or is it? In most cities, garbage is sent to a landfill. But what is a landfill? Let's do some dumpster diving and see for ourselves. This load of garbage is being brought to the city landfill in London, Ontario.
How you doing?
Good.
I got about 8 bags in there and an old slide. Yeah.
Some cities limit the number of garbage bags at the curbside. Anything extra must be brought to the landfill by the homeowner for various costs. In the hot temperatures of summer, garbage quickly begins to rot and attracts insects who lay eggs on its surface.
Did your maggots fall out?
Here's a disgusting one.
Let's see.
When the eggs hatch, maggots appear.
Where are your maggots?
I don't know. That's gross though.
Well, there's one.
Yeah. There's one down there. Oh, there's down on the ground there.
Yeah.
Nasty.
Insect-infested household garbage containing rotting food goes into small dumpsters, which are emptied often to discourage animals that may be attracted to them. Garbage that does not contain food, such as leftover building materials or old furniture, is placed into larger containers that take longer to fill up. This non-household bin holds a swimming pool, old carpets, floor tiles, wooden crates, and now holds a broken rubber water slide. Many landfills accept compostable waste separately, meaning yard trimmings, tree branches, and some foods, which will be turned into soil. Recyclable materials, like plastics, glass, and metal, are collected separately and sorted. Some metals are sold to scrap dealers, who recycle it or melt it down for raw materials. These metals can be used to make new items or very strange sculptures. Many scrap metal dealers accept metallic items for free, and they can simply be left in a dropping area so they can be sorted later, although the pile can get large after the dealer is closed for the day. What is the difference between a landfill and a dump? Landfills have special drain systems and are lined with waterproof materials to prevent toxins from leaking into groundwater. They also have layers of soil between garbage to prevent bad smells and discourage animals from scavenging. Dumps, on the other hand, don't have any lining or drainage systems. They're simply piles of garbage. They allow rainwater to mix with toxins. The toxins then pollute the groundwater as they soak downward. So, what does a dump look like? A dump may look like this one, which is located in Haviland Township in northeastern Ontario near Sault Ste. Marie.
Welcome to the Haviland Dump.
A dump is bulldozed a few times per year to flatten the garbage, but there is no system in place to contain the harmful pollutants. Proper landfills are expensive, and many rural areas cannot afford to build them. The garbage at Haviland, whether it contains toxic materials or not, is simply dumped. Haviland does operate a secondhand store where useful or non-useful items may be purchased. After all, one man's trash is another man's treasure. Sadly, most of the garbage here is not treasure and is simply buried in the ground. Another dump, only a few kilometers south of Haviland, was closed in the 1990s due to groundwater pollution. What happens when a dump or landfill is completely full? They are closed and garbage must be taken somewhere else. Landfills contain much of the mess, but dumps pollute groundwater for many, many years after closure. Garbage doesn't just go away. We make garbage much faster than it can be broken down. When your local landfill closes, where will your garbage go? Will a new landfill be built near your home? Do you leave litter for others to find? Think about what you leave behind, and try to leave a little less.